Okay, just let me know whether my screen is visible and I'm audible. Okay, just let me know whether I'm audible and my screen is visible. Last time what we have done, we have written a some points to draw it. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to add few lines, okay, which is a part of mapping which you will study later on. Okay, so presently you have to just understand these two lines are required, okay, for the transformation purpose, but later on you will study what do you mean by mapping. Okay, so context dot translate canvas dot width comma canvas dot height. Okay, then context dot scale 1, -1. So presently just these two lines we are going to require. Okay, just keep in mind this, that's it, nothing else. So I just save. Okay, then I switch to this, reset. Okay, press F12 key, go to console and create a maybe start point is equal to 100, 100, 1, that is what generally I am going to get it, and then I use point command and I specify my start point. Okay, so I got a point 100, 100 here. Maybe I need to reload it. Okay, just check it. Okay, so if I comment this and hit save, and let us see what happens on this. Reload. Width 800, canvas dot height 600. Okay, so this is clear. So reload. Okay, context dot translate is there and requires x and y. Okay, so I just translated full, so I need to modify this. So it has to be divided by 2 and divided by 2. Okay, and then this should be minus 1, canvas dot width by 2, canvas dot height by 2. Okay, so let's see if this is correct. So I just reload this. Okay, and now I just initialize point. Okay, so I got point here correctly. Okay, so now I can also specify my origin also. Say origin is equal to, let us say, everything 0. Okay, attribute has to be 1 only. And then I could say point maybe origin. Okay, so I got 0, 0 exactly at the center, and I got a P point at 100, 100. That is how I got it. Okay, so now, so these are the two lines which you need to add it. Okay, so now what you do, we have to rotate it. Let us say we have to rotate this point about the origin. Okay, that is what is the challenge. So what I am going to do it. Okay, so I am going to prepare a rotational matrix, and that is how it is going to work. Okay, so how do you do it? Okay, so I am going to prepare, let us say, C equal to, let us say I am going to rotate this point by angle 45 degrees. Okay, so I am going to say C equal to math dot, okay, so cos of 45, and of course I need to use radian converter. Okay, so math dot pi by 180. Okay, so I need to convert into a radian. So this is how it is C. Okay, and since sine 45 and cos 45 is same, so therefore I say S equal to C. Okay, so I just don't write in that way. So it's a simple. So I have now cos of theta, I have a sine of theta. Okay, so my rotation matrix R, so I use capital R, is equal to, that will be my, if you remember, cos theta minus sine theta. So cos theta cos theta minus sin theta 0, okay, and then next row will be sin theta, okay, then it will be cos theta 0, and the last row will be 0, 0 and 1. This will be my last row. So in this way my rotation matrix will be created. So you can see this is what is my rotation matrix, okay. So now my start point is what is called as 100 100 101. So let's rotate this point about the origin, okay. So what I am going to do, I am going to create a point again P1, that will be a point of course, and now I want to have a multiply. So if you remember last time we created a multiply, we need A matrix, B matrix, M matrix, N matrix and P matrix. My A matrix is my R matrix, okay, my B matrix is my ST matrix, and of course this is 3, 3, 1, okay, that is the number of rows, number of columns and number of columns in second matrix. So by rotating this, now I could see I got a P equal to these values, okay. So once I got these values, now it's only what I can do, I can just point this point P1. So I call this point P1. So you could see now the point P1 has appeared exactly. So this was a 45 degree, already it was located at 45 degree, now I am rotated and I got a point P1. So in this way I have achieved the rotation. So just let me know whether you got this or not. So to clear everything, just type clear and opening closing parenthesis, so everything will be clear, okay. So console will be basically cleared, so canvas will stay as it is. So in this way this is what is the task, okay. So now you can also rotate about any of the point also. So let's have a scaling effect with respect to point, okay. So I just reload it, and now what I do, first I have a point at the origin, okay. So let's pass it 0, 0, 1. In this way also you can pass the point, okay. So I got a point at 0, 0, 0, okay. So it's a very small dot. You can do it at your second, and then let us say we try to solve this problem, okay. Okay, point 2, 2, okay, it is rotated by it is scaled with respect to by 2 units in both the direction and rotated about a reference point 4, okay. So that matrix is 2, 2, 2, and this matrix will be -4, -4. So 2, 0, -4, 2, 0, -4, and this will be 2, 2, 1, okay. So initial point is 2, 2. So I am going to have point. So let's plot a point at 2, 2, 1, okay. Okay, sorry, this point will be at a very small distance. So I am just going to multiply it by 100. Okay, so 2 comma 2 is plotted, but this will be too near. So in hundreds we have to give the coordinates of points. So let's say it be 200. Okay, so now this 200 will be this point. Now what we do, instead of scaling twice, we will reduce the scale. Okay, we will reduce the scale with respect to that particular point. Okay, so now let's say I have another reference point which is at maybe say 100 comma 100. Okay, so 100 comma 100, this is what is the point. So now with respect to this 100 comma 100, the point 200 comma 200 will be scaled half. That is what is the target. Okay, so this point is reference point R point, and this point is P point, and I'm going to scale half. Okay, that is what is the target. So when I'm going to scale half, so this will be 0.5. okay, no, not 0.5, this will be now 100. Okay, reference point coordinate is 100 and this will be 0.5, so this will be 50 50. Okay, this will be 50 and 50. See, instead of 4, what is going to appear? 200. Okay, 100, sorry, instead of 4 it is going to be 100 and 100, because my reference point is at 100 comma 100. Okay, and my scaling effect is 1 minus 0.5. So it is going to come 0.5, 0.5 into 100, it is going to come 50. Okay, and my scaling factor is 0.5 and 0.5, instead of this 2, 2, so the, my scaling factor will come as a 0.5. Okay, so I create a capital S matrix, that will be my 0.5, comma 0, comma it will be 50, okay. Next will be 0 comma 0.5, this is my half the scaling factor, comma 50, and of course last one will be 0 comma 0 comma 1. So this is my S matrix, which I can see very clearly what is coming. Okay, so now let's move, let's create a point P1. Okay, and I will have a multiply. Okay, multiply with what? So the S matrix which I have created, and I don't have a B point which is at 200 comma 200. So let's, I did not store it, so no issue. I will pass this as a 200 comma 200 as a 1, it doesn't make any difference. Okay, so it is 3 comma 3 comma 1. I just close it. Okay, so now the 200 point is going to scale with respect to 100 comma 100 point. So you could see I got a P1 point as 150 comma 150 comma 1. So now I could say point, okay, P1, and just plot it. So you could see point P1 appear at the mid of this. So what has happened with respect to this point? Okay, with respect to this point, the topmost right corner point has been squared to half. Okay, so just let me know whether you got this concept or not. Okay, so I just show the code. So these are the things which you have to add it. Later on I will explain you how to draw the line and all the stuff. Okay, so presently you just go through this much only, and you can try out on your side how to work with. Okay, so now we will solve few problems. So just give me 2 minutes. I need to switch the screen. Okay. Now, so here we was previously. So since now we know many things, we know translation, okay, we know rotation about origin, we know rotation with respect to reference point, okay, we know scaling about origin, and now we know scaling with respect to R point, okay. So now we are set to go to solve one complex problem. Okay, so now let's try a problem. So I just write down the problem here. A point, okay, P let us say it is at maybe 4,4 is translated by say 5 units in x direction. And maybe let us say 4 units in y direction. Okay, this is the first step. Then it is scaled with respect to R point, which is located at let us say 2,2 by scaling factor Sx equal to 2 and Sy equal to 1.5. So I will be having a different scaling in both x and y direction. Okay, and after that third operation, then it is rotated by angle 45 degrees. Okay, find new orientation of point P. Okay, so let's go down how it is going to come. Okay, so I'm going to have P dash. So three operations are there, so therefore I will require three matrices, so which I am going to write here. The first matrix is the last matrix. So rotation is what my last matrix. Now it is not mentioned whether it is rotated with respect to any point. Okay, so that means by default it is rotated about the origin. Okay, so my first rotation matrix will be, and the direction is not mentioned. So by default direction is anticlockwise if it is not mentioned. So I am going to write 0.707 minus 0.707, this will be 0, 0.707, this will be 0.707, this will be 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, and the next matrix is scaling with respect to 0.2. Okay, so scaling factor is 2. 0, here it is going to come 1.5. okay, so that is 1 minus XR. Okay, XR into 1 minus SX, so 1.5, 1 minus SX, it should be there. Okay, and the reference coordinates are 2. Okay, so 2 minus 1 minus 2, that is 1 minus SX, 0, 1.5, 2, that is reference point, 1 minus 1.5, and this will be 0, 0, 1. And the first operation, which is going to be last operation, and which is translation by 5 units in x direction and the 4 units in y direction. Okay, so this is what is my translation operation. 1, 1, 1. Okay, fine. Okay, so this is my is equal to P dash, and this will be multiplied by my point P. Okay, and my point P is 4, 4, and 1. So now here in this case I am going to get my P dash. Okay, okay, just try out these values and let me know the answer. okay, just solve this and let me know the answer. Okay. So, I suppose you are getting this answer, 3.534, and 19.089, and this will be 1, okay. So this is what is the most probable answer you might be getting it. So Tejas has posted the answer. Just let me know everybody got the answer or not. The question is to everyone. Okay, I'm waiting for 2 minutes more. Everyone has to solve. Okay, so now let's go to another point, another problem. A line AB, A coordinate 2, 3, and B coordinate say 10, 15. Is rotated about R whose coordinate is 4, 4 by an angle (45°). Okay, then it is scaled by two. It is scaled by two. Then it is translated by say 6 units in x direction. Okay, so this is what is the problem given to you. Okay, so now how to solve. Okay, so this is something like this. Okay, so here in this case this will be my A dash and this will be my B dash is equal to first rotation matrix, then scaling matrix, and finally translation matrix. And here in this case is a coordinate matrix. Okay, so my rotation matrix with respect to reference point 4, 4. Okay, so just we will go back. Okay, this was the derivation. Okay, cos theta sin theta xr 1 minus cos theta yr sin theta. So you just have to recall these values. Okay, so xr is 4, 1 minus 0.707, okay, plus 4 into 707. So yr sin theta and xr cos theta will get cancelled and I will get only 1 into xr, that is 4. Okay, and next time what I will get, so this is 4 minus 8.707. so that is what I am going to get. Okay, so I just write down this critical value. Here I am going to get only 4. Okay, so I just move back again. So xr my cos theta plus y cancel, xr is 4, 4, and this is going to be 8, 4. So 4 minus 8 into 0.707, 4 minus 8 into 0.707, so it is coming minus 1.656. so you have to verify this, okay, whether this is correct or not. So last time also I made a mistake here itself. So minus 1.656. This will be 0.70. Okay, sorry. Rotated about. So this is the first matrix. So it is going to come at the last. Okay, so since it is the first matrix, it is going to come at the last. So I have a 0.707 minus 0.707, and here it will be 4 minus. Okay, so I'll make this as a bigger so I can write it. Okay, and this is my point. So 0.707 minus 0.707. This is going to come 4 minus 1.656. This will be 0.707. This will be 0.707. This will be 0, 0, 1. Okay, this is what is the first matrix, and then it is a scaling matrix by 2 units. Okay, so it is when it is mentioned that by 2, so by default in both the direction it is 2. 0, 0, 1, and the last matrix is the first matrix, that is only translation 0. So by 6 units, 0, 1, there is no transformation in y direction, so therefore it is 0. Okay, so just multiply this, and this will be my A point and B point. So this is 2, 3, 1, and that will be 10, 15 and 1. This is my A and this is my B. Okay, so when you use that particular multiply section, okay, so what you are going to do, you are going to transfer A, you are going to transfer B, you are going to say 3, all these have multiplied. Okay, so this has been multiplied and you got 3/3 resultant. And then you are passing that resultant as a in form of A, so 3, 3, and for coordinate, now the instead of 1 column will be 2. Okay, so that is how you have to multiply. Okay, and then you are going to get A dash and B dash. So first thing is, just let me know whether this is correct or not. So the rotation matrix what we got is correct or not, just let me know. Okay. So someone has a query. So now what I do, I go, so you just read it, rotate it by about 4,4, okay, and by angle of 45 degrees, about 4,4. So I just go ahead at the top and we'll copy that stuff. Okay, so let's I just copy this. And bring it here. Okay, great. So now since it is available here, so I can now have H. Sorry, yeah. So I could have now H equal to, why this happens? Okay. Okay. Now cos theta. So angle is 45. So I just move over. Angle is 45. So therefore cos of theta is 0.707, sin theta will be minus 0.707. okay, now xr is my 4, okay, 4 minus you could consider 0.707, 1 minus 0.707, 1 minus 0.707, 0.293. So this is 0.293. Okay, and then plus yr, so yr is also 4 into sin theta, so that is 0.707. okay, so it is becoming small, so you have to understand that it is like that, 0.707, and then I have minus 4 of 0.707 sin theta plus 4 of, okay, 4 of will be 0.293. So 1 minus cos theta, that is 1 minus 0.07, and this will be 0.001. And now you just do calculation and let me know now whether this is correct or not. I am talking about this matrix. Okay. So everyone has to reply. So I repeated the rotation matrix, so I hope everyone got it. Okay, so it is correct. Okay, so everyone has to calculate. It is likely possible that I am going to make a mistake. So we should have a correct answer. Okay, so now A dash and B dash, you can get it. If this is correct, it's a simple thing. Multiplication of three matrices, in fact, four matrices now. Okay, and just let me know the answer. Okay, so 12.58, 6.93, 3.76, 32.04, and this will be 11. See, when we use computational tools, so many things becomes a lot easier. Okay, this is a mechanical work, multiplication and doing stuff that we are not interested. We are interested in solving the problem and getting the result, and for that purpose you have to use computer. Okay.